Hey guys.
Hello.
Welcome to a surprise edition of Tilted Tabletop, where we are testing new equipment, we're playing a relaxing game, and having a chill Sunday stream.
Yes. This music actually almost too lively for me, so I'm gonna have to...
Ooh, Saving Show Throws hosting.
Hello, everybody.
Hello, everyone.
Yeah, this is not a normal segment for us. We came in on Sunday to test some new equipment, and we thought we might as well test it live once we got everything working, so yeah. We'll see.
So we're going to play a game of Patchwork. It's a two-player, lightly competitive game. I'd say it's more like, I don't know, I don't find it to be like really competitive, but yeah, it's about building a superb patchwork quilt.
Yes. I love this game. We've both played this before, which is also new for our stream, to have played a game before and just live stream it.
Yeah, like the novelty effect. This is a game, though, I don't mind playing over and over again. It's like, you know, I wouldn't want to play like every week, but it's definitely a really fun two-player game.
Yes. It was one of my favorite two-player games when people ask me what kind of games I suggest, and I'm just like, who are you looking for? And a lot of time it's like couples that are looking for a game.
Yeah, it's always hard. I think two is hard.
It is.
Because most games it's like, okay, 2 to 8 players, like 2 to 6 players, and the two is never good.
Yes. This is one that I would actually be like, do you want a game that's actually good for two players? Play this one. And it's only like 2-player only. You can play this with more players. So, yeah.
You want to do some like light, I mean, it's so simple to start too. Do you want to just kind of walk through how this goes?
It is. So the purpose of this game is we have these boards that we're going to fill in and we're going to make like the best quilt we possibly can. And we have all these pieces that we can pick from. And it's kind of a, what are those games called where you like have to keep an eye on the shape because you need them to fit.
I just think like Tetris, like it's a Tetris style game.
It is, yes, it's very much like Tetris. So what you would do is you, we have this which goes here. And this little man will tell us where we can pick from. And what it is we can pick 1, 2, or 3 after the guy. We have an option from these. The cost, this makes it awkward. I don't know if you can see, but the cost is, it'll be seven to buy and then 2 time. And what that means is that I have, we start with.
Yeah, that's what I forget. I think it's like 5 or something.
I think it's 5. That was the one thing I can never remember.
Crit Camp, thanks for the host.
Thanks for the host, Crit Camp. Sorry guys, I'm just looking. How many we play with? 5.
Okay. Probably actually want individuals too.
Yeah. So these are so cute because they're like little buttons. So that's 5 buttons.
Buttons is your money.
And so we can use that to buy these based on the cost that it says. And then the little time is how much we move forward on this board. This is a shared board. So I think I'm green and Steve's yellow. So the time would be if I bought something that costs 4 time, that would mean I move 1, 2, 3, 4. And why this is important is that you only have a certain number of moves. You move through this board, once you're here, that's it, you're out of moves. So there's both spending your buttons and also watching your time and working around that. Every time you pass one of these on the board, you get income. What income is the number of buttons you have on the board. So if I have this piece, it has 2 buttons on it. And if that piece is on my board, when I hit income, I would calculate how many I had. So if I had both these pieces on my board, I would get 3 income whenever I pass that button.
And it's a little bit of a trade-off. So some of the more difficultly shaped pieces have more...
Thanks for the follow.
Good stream.
If
it's weird shaped, like this one, you know, might be hard to fit. It tends to have like more button income or some kind of thing, and you have to kind of pair the gain from like buttons with like how hard it will be to actually fit that on your board.
So. Yes.
And same thing with time, like you might, for an easier thing, you might, time might go forward much faster.
Yeah, and because there's also these little patches on the board, and these are singles. These are the only singles that exist in the game. And so whoever passes that patch first gets that single. So sometimes you want to go faster. And then the last thing is to get income. So let's say I can't afford any of the three in front of me.
Serenity Game Club, thanks for the host.
If I can't afford any of the ones in front of me, I, let's say you are up here. I can go, okay, I'm not going to take anything. I'm just going to go forward. So I'm going to 1, 2, 3, 4, because I always move ahead of you by one. And then however many spaces I moved, I take that much money. So that helps when I'm like, okay, I can't afford something, or I want more money. And that's how you would get it without getting button income.
Mm-hmm. I have two questions that I forget. One is, your game doesn't end until you reach the center. So if you finish early, I can keep going.
Yes. You keep going until you also reach the center.
Okay, and my other question is on... I forget my other question. Oh, with the special patches, do you use it immediately or do you bank it and you can use it whenever you want?
No, you have to use it immediately. Okay. So that's kind of like picking up, like, okay, if I buy this one, it'll leave that one space, and like, can I bank that I'm going to get that one? Because at the end game scoring has to do with... you count up how many buttons you have left. And then, let me pull up endgame scoring, just so you know. So how many buttons you have left, and then you add the value of special tiles, if available. So whoever finishes a 7x7 first gets this bonus 7 points. So that's included in your total. And then you subtract 2 points for every empty space that's left on your board.
That's always where I lose.
Yeah, you will usually be like, oh, okay, now I have, I was like, yes, I have 30 buttons. And then you're like, now I have 5 points.
I have 4. Yeah. And you can have negative, right? You can just like basically just lose everything. Okay.
Yeah, it usually comes down to like a 10-point game in the end. You always have some space left, but it's definitely trying to have as much little spaces uncovered as possible, which is why it's really important to watch your spaces. Oh, the portal gun. Yeah,
It's signed by everyone that worked on the game.
Yeah, we're sitting in the Twitch office right now, and so we're in what's called Aperture Laboratories, which is one of the meeting rooms.
Can they see the, oh yeah, they can see some of the little, little
artwork.
What are they called?
Turrets?
Yeah.
Yeah, this room's pretty cool. This is one, whenever my friends come over, I'm like, oh, you have to see this room.
Hey, Weston. See, here's one.
Hey, Weston. We'll have to check out. I'm going to follow your stream. I have to remember. That bright green is really hard to read when you're not in dark mode.
Crooked stream, I think.
Crooked stream. Got it. I'll follow you later, I promise.
How do you decide who goes first?
I mean, I like to use Schwazi, but...
I feel like there's some kind of hokey rule, like the last person to wrap themselves in a quilt or something. Or sew something.
It says, player who last used a needle. Do you do any sewing, Steve? Have you repaired like a button on a shirt?
You can use a needle for other things too. But I don't think I even own a needle. I'm not even used a needle.
Used a needle. I haven't done sewing in a while. Actually, yeah. Claire,
happy fun time live. Hello, thanks for the host.
Thank you. Claire and I are actually, we've signed up for a quilting thing, and what they do is they send you the pre-cut pieces.
Did you touch it?
I haven't. It has not arrived yet, so I can't use that one. Let's just use Schwazi.
Okay.
Let's make this easy. I almost opened the stream by accident.
That would have been great.
Fiacra. John, Weston, John. Schwazi. I do have it. Cool. I don't know if you guys have ever used this app before, but it's fantastic. Ready?
Oh, I love this sound. Ooh.
And then
I won.
Steve. Steve's first. It works, I think, up to 5 or 6 people you can put on it, so it works really well.
Is it just, like, wait for, like, the number of fingers to stop changing for, like, 5 seconds?
Yeah.
Cool. So I'm going clockwise?
Yes.
And I can pick up to the any of these?
Up to the three in front of you.
Okay. I can't afford any of them.
Oh, God. I have a full cup of tea.
What do I do if I can't afford anything?
You could afford these ones. But if you...
Oh, I see. Sorry. I can. Okay. Then I think I'm going to... That's a little scary, isn't it?
Yeah, it's not a great start, but...
Okay, I think I'm going to spend 5 buttons to get... I'm going to buy this biggie here. This is pretty scary, huh? I'll do this.
Yeah, this is an interesting start.
Okay, and this goes here.
Sorry for the rustling. We got tea and cookies. Like we
went. I dipped the tea in. I dipped the cookies in, and it tasted so good with the mint tea. I don't know what kind of tea you got.
Mine is a. You should smell. It's like a. It's like it's got peppermint, like candy cane bits and white chocolate.
Oh, is this from like David's tea
or whatever?
It's totally
from David's.
Okay,
tea.
I was gonna say like.
It's not in the office.
Someone got me once like a birthday cake tea, and it had like little sprinkles or something in it.
Mm-hmm. Some of them come like that. This was one of the Christmas ones.
It smells great.
It's so good. So it's like a mint tea, but it's
oh, and
like
I have to move.
Tea.
So I put time forward 3 spaces. So 1, 2, 3.
Perfect. I'm going to spend 2.
Oh, see, that's a really good one.
1, 2. And so...
Oh, it doesn't have any button income, so that's why.
Yeah, it does not.
It's a great corner piece.
So I'm still actually... I forgot this rule. I'm still behind you.
Oh, so you get to go again.
So turn order after the first one goes whoever is behind.
I forgot, yeah. Okay.
So I move this here because I took that piece, and then I go again.
And that's how they make it, so basically, like, you couldn't be, I couldn't be, like, way ahead of you and then end the game, like, 10 turns early.
Yeah. Now, there's kind of a cheeky rule that sometimes we'll play with that is if you can't, like, you can eyeball it, and but if you buy it and fuck up, that's the, like, once you put it on the board. So people aren't, like, pulling, testing.
Yeah, I agree with that.
Okay. Because here's me, like, trying to go, is that the right size piece?
Yeah.
I'm going to go for it. So, 1. To buy this one.
It was only 1?
It's not the right size.
Well, you better hope you get one of those.
No! It's my fault. I was like, let's play with that rule, because it's just more fun. Well, let's hope I get the tiny one. I don't even know how else I would do this. I'm going to hope I get one of those singles, and then I move up 2.
It is kind of a Tetris-y game. Okay, let's see. So now it's my turn, and I really can't... Mint chip tea, that sounds great.
Yeah, that one's really... That's a green tea, too.
Okay, I am just... Wow.
John and I drink a lot of tea.
I'm just going to lap you, and then I get 1 button, I guess.
You get, so you move 2 spaces, right? So you move here, you move a total of 2 spaces, and then you also get 1 button for your income. Does that make sense?
I get just 1 button total, right?
So you didn't buy a piece, right?
Correct.
Ooh, I think this was here, actually. Sorry, I didn't move it.
Oh, okay.
In case you wanted to buy. So you're moving, you're jumping in front of me, so you move 1, 2 spaces, so you get 2 buttons, and then you also pass an income space, so you get your income also.
Okay, I forgot that the moving thing was just a bank, an income-based play. Okay, so I'm going to get 3 buttons.
Yep. And then it's my turn again.
Yeah.
So, I have no button income. Which is going to be a problem. I was like, ooh, these pieces are all really nice.
They are nice. So that is the trade-off with this game. Like, you know, you can have, like, nice, easy-to-fit things, but you don't really get paid with them.
Mm-hmm.
It's one of those games where, like, economy actually does matter toward the end where you're, like, you know, wanting some of these weird ones.
Yeah.
Because I should say, like, some of these are, like, 7 buttons just to buy 1 piece.
Yeah, this one had a bunch of income on it. It was worth, like, it was 10 to buy.
Dang. Let me turn off my screen saver. Sorry. I'm going to reach.
You're fine. I think I'm going to do what you just did. So I'm going to go 1, 2. I don't have any button income, but I get 2 from doing the jump. You know, people are going to come to this stream and be like, why are you guys called Tilted Table? It's very, like, calm in here.
I think we need a stream like this every once in a while. So it's my turn again, and that hasn't moved, so...
Also, I do want to say, like, guys, look at our nice new camera.
Yeah, do you see? You can see all, like, the there's colors here. You can actually make out, like, what's happening on the board. You can see our quilt.
Yeah, it's... Much, much, much better.
Wow, okay. So I think I messed up on my first placement, but I'm just gonna have to roll with it. Yeah, I really messed up with that first placement. okay, here's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna spend 2 buttons to get this long one. I'm gonna put it there. Is that dumb? Well, we'll figure it out. We'll figure it out later.
It's definitely, yeah. I found that I like working out of a corner because being the first one to get this, 7
yeah,
points is
good.
A lot. So. And did you move? So you moved 2.
Oh, yeah. Time went ahead 2.
Okay. I'm going to buy that 4 button piece.
The polka dot?
I think so. What's the other one? It's a 3 button. That one is income, but it's not as big.
That's the trick.
All right, I'm going to go for income because I feel like I'm going to get screwed
one?
If I don't. Yeah.
Go.
Thank you.
So this goes there. Oh, wow, that's good. That was a good one.
And then I move forward too.
Okay. Oh, wow. I really can't do anything, so I'm gonna lap you and take 2.
Yeah, that's the other strategy of this game is like, well, if I want to cut somebody off of one of the pieces, you're like, you almost have to go. You're like, well, that piece would be really good for Steve,
yeah.
So maybe I should do that. But
I'm like so quilt challenge right now that.
I don't think I can afford anything.
Yeah.
I can't afford anything.
That's where I am right
1,
now.
2. I'll take 2 buttons.
so I have 3. These are all weird shaped. Okay, I think I'm going to take... Oh, wow, I can't afford that. I thought I could... Okay, I'm not going to take anything. Oh, wow. Okay, I'm going to... I'm just going to lap you. I'm going to have to do that again. So I get 2 plus an income. And you get an income as well. Oh, wait. You only get it when you pass it?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. All right, I'll move us forward. I will buy for 2 here. And then I move forward 1. I get 1 income. I think I go again.
Because you're on the same
didn't,
space.
Yeah, because I didn't pass you. Move your turn. You always move. Da-da-da-da-da-da. It is. Where is it? The player who's on top goes first. Yep. Okay. So, I guess I could afford, all right, I'm gonna buy this one.
You really need to buy some...
I don't know if that's going to screw me over later. Oh, God. Yeah, I'm just going to go there. That's both my buttons, and I move forward to 3.
Okay. So I am going to spend 3 buttons to get this little piece. Do that. And then I go forward 1. So then I gotta go again.
Yep.
I am going to spend, oh my gosh, I'm gonna spend 1 button to buy this. Mm-hmm. And I go forward, oh wow, it's really tight. I go forward 5. And I get an, does that count my income, the one I just bought?
Yes. Okay. So you get 2 income.
Okay. Here we go.
Okay. I have no money. So I'm forced to just go forward. 1, 2, 3, 4 plus 2 income. So I get 6.
Dang, that's a lot. Okay, I'm gonna spend. My gosh, I'm gonna spend 3 to grab this one. And I go forward 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. So I have this and I have to place it immediately, correct?
Which one?
This little guy here.
Yes.
Okay, so I guess that's gonna go there.
I needed that. I needed that.
This is all like fortuitous, like this all is suddenly coming together. I did not expect, like actually I didn't even see that one. I was like, okay, well I guess I can get like the stick one and like be a little better off.
Mm-hmm. No, like it somehow worked. Man, okay. I at least have a bunch of income to spend.
Yeah, you do.
I'm gonna do...
Oh, you have some good choices there.
Yeah. I'm actually gonna do 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 to take this one.
Oh.
Because it'll go there.
Nice.
And I move forward 5.
Oh, it has 2 button income too. That's pretty good.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then I take 4 income.
My gosh. I think I'm gonna have to do an income pass here. I only have
there
1 button.
There is a 1.
There is a 1, actually. I don't know how helpful that is for me. I am very... Well... Okay, actually I'm gonna spend the 1 to get this. Oh shit. It's not really what I wanted. But I'll do it. So I'll move here. And then I'm just go forward 1 and then I'm just gonna
2. Move. You go forward 2.
I'll go forward 2 and then I'm can't do anything, so I'll do 1, 2. So I'll take 2 buttons plus 1, 2, 3.
All right, I will. Ooh, I can't afford that nice big long one. It's a 7.
That is one I would also like to have. I've been eyeing everything that looks like that.
All right, I'm gonna go for the weird one, which actually is gonna block you. I'm sorry for taking it.
The H?
Because I'm gonna go for the H.
Oh, I needed that, huh? I could have used that.
Oh, this one, because now it's passed.
Oh, I'll get it. I'm actually going to do a little
consolidation. So I need to move forward.
Here.
3. 1, 2, 3. Ooh, where is that? 3. Yes.
Did you get the piece?
Yes. I got the piece, guys. I got the
lucky.
Piece.
Lucky.
I should, yeah. Consolidating lets me move this forward so people can see.
Yeah,
they can see my beautiful quilt.
Okay, so I have five. It's here now. Okay, let's see. There's four. I could afford that one, which isn't terrible. I might take that one. Oh, I go for it. Six, though. That's crazy. Oh.
But yeah, so as I was saying, Raven and I are, they send you, like, every month they send you a piece of the quilt. And it goes like, oh, okay, so neat. Here's a pattern for a piece of it, and you stitch what you got. And they give you all the little pieces pre-cut. And they do that for 10 months. And then at the end, they give you the final, like, and this is how it goes together. So it's like a mystery quilt.
Does it have, like, a certain, like, theme? Is it just, like...
I get to pick the color scheme.
Oh, okay.
But I don't know what the pattern's going to look like.
So I have two identical ones. One is more income, and it's more expensive. Oh, wow. It's much more expensive on time. So I think I'm going to spend the four... I'm going to spend the four on this one. Okay. It's going to go here. So how many seven? One, two, three, four, five. I want the 7x7s like this, right?
It is pretty big. Two, three, four, five, six, seven. So, yeah. Okay. Cutting out the last two.
Okay, so I move forward to one, two.
I think you're on top of me. That patch is in a space.
Oh, okay. And I go again. Mm-hmm. Well, I only have one button, so I can't do anything. So I'm going to move forward one and take one.
All right. I am... I'm trying to like judge the length of that shape. Oh, I can't afford it anyway. No, I can only afford that tiny one.
It's not a terrible piece.
I'm gonna
take
it. It's actually a pretty good piece.
Yeah. If I had any income, I would have immediately bought that. For that,
go
what
right
you're doing right
up
now.
Here, in this corner, and then I move one. But then I can't afford anything, so I'm just gonna move one and take one button.
Okay, I only have two, and I can't afford anything, so I'm gonna lap you. So I get two for that, right? Mm-hmm. Yeah, one, two, and then I get
plus your income.
One, two, three, four. Okay. Let's see. What is available? Oh, I'm done, actually. I was like, can I buy now? No. Though you can't buy either.
I cannot afford, so I'm going to go one, two plus my four income, so I get six.
Okay, let's see. So now I have, okay, one, two, three, four. I have eight. Holy gosh. Okay. That's a 10 button one. I was like, maybe I'll buy that weird one. No, I'm not going to buy anything. I think I buy the T looking one. Okay, that goes one, two, three, four. One, two, three. Okay, actually, I do buy that. Yeah, it's seven. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. It's like everything I own. And then buy this. I believe it goes right here.
Nice.
And then I go forward. Oh, only two. That's really good, actually.
Yeah.
Did not see that. Okay. One, two.
I can buy that one or that one. I really want this one, but it's so expensive.
And you'll notice, like, basically everything left that we can has buttons on it now, because it's like all the fairly expensive stuff.
Yeah, usually when I play this game, I like to play a high income game. So I'll go for the ones that are more expensive but have a bunch of buttons. Because I found, like, later, then your income's so much higher than the other person. But just the way the board was set up, I didn't have the opportunity. And so now you're balancing, like, okay, the income's not as good now because I won't be able to utilize it as much. But I still need it. I need the space.
Oh, shoot.
Oh, no. We've lost Chad. Okay, I am just going to... Yeah, I'm going to go for the weird one so I get income. So five. Take this.
Oh, that one.
Mm-hmm. It's got two buttons on it. It's a weird, really weird shape, though.
Oh, and you get the...
1, 2, 3, 4.
Yeah, that's pretty good.
I don't know where I'm gonna put the patch, though. I have to think.
I mean, I have a suggestion, but I'm not gonna tell you. I'll tell you after.
It's like looking what's left on the board that I'm going to be able to.
But also, like, can you actually get that thing? Like, will you actually have the opportunity to buy that thing?
I think I'm going to go here. All right. I'm committed. That's it.
I am going to lap you. I think I can take income. Oh, where did I move from? Shoot, here, right?
Mm-hmm.
So 1, 2, 3, 4. 3, 4 plus 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay.
I'm gonna do the one.
That's what I thought you would do. Yeah. Though I didn't actually plan for, like, what I would do once you did that.
That's why I didn't put this one here.
I was gonna suggest, I would have suggested that, just because, like, getting into there is gonna get harder and harder.
Yeah.
To make sure. Okay. So, okay, I have a lot of choices now. Well, not that they all work for me, but I have a lot of choices. 1, 2. I can't tell if this is what I think it is. Okay. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, here's 10. And I'm gonna hope that this works. Oops, this goes here.
And you move up 3?
Yes, I move 3.
1, 2, 3. All right. I am going to buy. I only have 2 buttons. This one's free.
What? Actually, but I see why it's free. It's like the, like, nastiest.
I don't have anywhere to put it. Oh, it would fit here.
It would
here.
Fit there, but then you're like, you have a bunch of, like, weird, there's nothing else that can really go around this.
Yeah.
We took all the babies. I like the little 3 ones. Actually, I think you got every single one of those little.
I did get the little one.
No, I have one. I got one of them.
Oh, man. I really want these 10 pieces, and I can't afford them.
Yeah, that's where I'm at.
I really want this
one. Same. I really want that one.
I feel like we're just at the race of who can afford the really 10 ones in front of us.
Well, otherwise the game's not really going to move too much.
Yeah. Like, I need to move. I'm just going to do this.
Two? Okay. Two. Well, I only have one. I'm not taking that free one. I don't know what I'd do with it. Well, no. I'm not doing it. Well, no. I'm going to just do two myself. I think we're at like a two cycle of that.
I'm gonna do it.
Wow.
It's too good to pass up.
It is free.
It is free.
And you move.
And then I move 1, 2, 3, and I get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 income.
Well, I can't do anything, so I have to lap you. I'm a little mad that you're gonna get the thing next and get to buy. Okay, so I'm gonna do 1, 2, 3. So I get 3 plus my income, which is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, so I'm like flush with buttons.
I mean, I'm doing the obvious. I'm spending 8. Let's take this one. Put it here.
Does that mean you get
I
the
move
thing?
6.
Do you get the... I think you get the 7
no,
by 7.
No, this...
Oh,
oh wait.
Okay.
No, wait, I do. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I do!
Lucky.
But I moved 6. That's a lot.
Wow.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I take this, which I had to put it somewhere.
This is where I get wrecked.
I guess I'll put another one there. And then I also take income. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
Wow, that wasn't a good turn for you at all. Okay, so, so, okay, so I'm going to spend, I think I'm going to spend 3 to take this one, which I'll put there. And then I'm going to spend...
So you move up 3.
I move up 3. 1, 2, 3. And then I'm going to spend 2 to get this one. Put there. And I
nice.
Move up 2.
Ah, then you go
and
again.
Then I go like so. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9.
This becomes the like... The trade-off of getting those ones are just so much time.
Look how many, like, you just bank so much money, like, right at the end. I always forget that part. Okay, so now I get to go again. I'm going to spend 7 to get this one.
Oh, that's such a good piece.
Put there. And then I move 1. It's your turn. Oops. We are very close to the end, though.
We are.
Wait, I think when does the income happen again?
You get one right before you. Oh, you did get that one. It's just right when you pass the end. You kind of like bank all the extra ones for your final
score.
Got it.
Okay.
So there's no more. This is all you have left to spend for this.
Okay.
I am. This should fit here. Or at least here, and then I'll cross the finish, I think. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah, let's just do that. 10 for this one.
Dang. I think I have lost big time.
And then I go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I take this thing. And then I bank. I get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13.
You have 13 buttons?
Yeah.
Okay.
So
3, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. Dang, okay. So I'm going to spend 4 buttons on this. Move up 2. And then you lose 2 points for every empty open space, right?
Yeah.
So it makes sense to buy that.
The big fat ones, yeah.
Yeah. So I think I'm going to spend my last buttons in the world to buy this. I'll just stick it there. And then I move 4. So here, and then I get, okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12.
So you get 12 at the end. That's only one off me.
Yeah. Okay.
So you take your, yeah. So final score, this game's pretty quick. We take our buttons, mm-hmm. plus bonuses if we have them.
There's only one bonus. That's such like a humble brag rule, like plus you add your bonus. You know, it's for the audience, I'm sure.
Yeah, yeah. And then you count these up, multiply that by 2, and subtract that from your total. So.
20. So I have negative... negative 8. 16,
18, 20, 22. So that's... sorry, I have that 17, 18, 19, 20, 21,
22, 23. So I have 1 point. No, I have negative 8, so you won by 9. Basically, like, getting the 7 by 7, like... We would have been within like 3 had that not been there.
Yeah. That's Patchwork.
Dang. You know, I kind of wonder though, like, do you really need to subtract 2 for each? Like, could it just be 1? Like, there's no, like, the scale of it doesn't, well.
It does scale.
It does matter, yeah, I guess it matters.
Yeah, it would not be as bad. The actual, like, amount of space that they take. I imagine they probably play tested and found like, yeah. No, 2 makes more sense.
Well, I'm just curious, like, how good could I have really gotten? Like, is there anything else that would at this point actually, like,
you would have covered less space?
Like, nothing fits. So I could have gotten, like, I don't think it's actually possible for anyone to fill their whole board.
I've never seen total. I think I've seen like 2 or 3 left, but nothing crazy.
The best I could have done was get this last piece, and you know, I would have gotten net 4 buttons.
I'm sure there's like more math that could go involved in this. We were like, well, this one is technically worth.
Yeah, but like, if you're doing that, you don't understand what this game is trying to do, which is like.
It's relaxing. Yeah,
look how cool. Now look at now. I think the other cool thing is just like looking how cool your quilt looks. I'm gonna move this out so we can like.
Show off
our quilts.
I can't zoom unless I stand on the table. We'll have to figure that out. It's a new camera and we're trying to figure out how to make it work.
Yeah.
But yeah, that's Patchwork. That's it. Pretty simple.
I always forget, like, I like this game. It's such a nice game. I really want to play Country Garden because it's like a 4-player version of it. Yeah, you're like building a garden. You have little like these little animals in your garden, like cats. I think there's cats and birds, maybe, or just cats.
Really? I've never played Cottage Garden.
Oh, Cottage Garden. Yeah, sorry. I'll bring it in. We'll play it the next few months probably.
We have so many games. We're like, we need to play this one and this.
I think we're probably like 15 to 20 games behind. Like, no joke, because I have like 6 to 8 alone, and Jordan has a bunch.
I have ones that are like in my collection. I was like, oh yeah, if we have time and stuff, I've got great games that I love.
What's that one game that is supposed to be basically like Battlestar Galactica, like the game, but only like a 45-minute version of it? It's basically like the same type of game, but they get rid of all that.
I remember.
Someone told us about it.
Yeah.
And we looked it up and we're like, oh, we should. I was thinking about that game like this weekend, because I was on RPG Geek. looking at the top 20 are like I was looking at their top one shots list.
Oh, okay, cool.
And I saw a lot of like mystery slash like whatever RPGs, and I remembered it. But to that end, I saw a lot of cool like one shots. Around, but some of them are like murder. A lot of them are like murder mystery ones, which are kind of interesting. I've never done something like that before. I've only ever done like medieval kind of, you know, magic type.
That's true. I've done like fantasy and I've done sci-fi. I had a friend who like really wanted to do like a modern day one where we were, I think we still had magic, but it was like we were part of like a like almost a police force that investigated magic within.
Like
Dresden Files.
I was gonna say it's Dresden Files.
Yeah. Dresden Files actually has an RPG system.
I did not know that. I haven't watched that show. I know there's
the
book.
The show is awful.
I only saw the show.
Don't watch the show.
But if you only saw the show, you probably wouldn't know what you were missing, right?
Yeah, you'd still be like, this show is
Yeah.
And then people who've read the books are like, this show is crap.
It got canceled. I was consuming it. It's okay. It's like quirky. It's fun. If you like that camp, I love campy sci-fi shows, so I was like, I'm not turned off by like
so
how.
So the book is campy, and what I think the best part of the book with it was the character Bob. And in the show,
he's like a person. It's like a.
He's a person. In the other one, he's like a spirit that inhabits a skull, which I get. Like if you have you want to make it more interesting to watch, I get that. But then he's like this stuck-up British guy, and the other one is like he's, you could envision it with a British accent, but he's like. Dresden pays him in porno mags to get information. Like, he's a crude, funny demon, and in this here, like, uptight British guy. And I was like, what did they do?
So I can see, like, totally changing a key character. Like, I never knew any better, so it worked.
And Dresden is less, like, snippy or fast on his words, I think. I don't know. It was a lot of the characters were not done in the way that you, like, are used to them. That was my
Do you have anything more to say about Patchwork?
Oh, do we want to do like our
maybe just like you can cover whatever you want, but just get like you get your own like minute to go over it.
As I said, this is a game I recommend for people when they ask me for a two-player recommendation. This is the date night game that I recommend people. Oh, hey, Double Hawk.
Better late than never, Double Hawk. I took this on vacation and
this
it was
like surprise.
It was great on vacation, like having a drink at night or like sun setting. You know, you can play this like outside. You could bring this outside easily, like, and you could just put all this. You don't even need the box. You could put this all in like a bag and just bring it with you on vacation. Like the pieces are really sturdy, so you're not gonna like the buttons. There's nothing you can really hurt. Put it in like a what's it called? Quart, not a quart size, but the gallon size plastic bag. 13
Ooh.
Hours.
That sucks.
We just got done playing a 30-minute game, so we really know how you feel, Double Hawk.
Oh, Double Hawk, you're fine. This was a surprise stream. We were testing out new camera.
Do you see, Double Hawk? Do you see that you can see the board?
We were like, hey, we should just test not on our regular time just to make sure things are working and so I can watch the VOD later and pick it apart, which will be fun.
Yeah.
And if you guys have any suggestions for changing the stream up and what we could do, I'd love to hear them. This is kind of what I like to do, is put little improvements in our production quality as I go.
And we have a really cool stream where we're going to use this new camera setup this Wednesday. Slugfest Games is joining us again. They just launched Red Dragon and Seven on Kickstarter.
Yeah.
So we're gonna and we're playing that game. Like we're gonna play Red Dragon and Seven, correct?
I don't know for sure.
I don't know if we're playing Red Dragon Inn or Red Dragon and Seven.
I know we're giving away copies of Red Dragon Inn 7.
No, Red Dragon Inn.
Red Dragon
vanilla
Inn.
Game.
Oh, are we? Oh, that's still cool.
Yeah, to go with the
So you could win it and then you just back the Kickstarter for the extra stuff. So
yes.
I was looking it up. Actually, that makes sense because Red Dragon Inn 7 is adding like the characters that you're used to in Red Dragon Inn. So yeah, it's like the bartender, or the wench, is one of the characters that are now playable, and that's how they did it. So it seems really cool.
Yeah. Yeah, we're giving away copies. Check out our Twitter. You can, we have a Gleam thing running. You can win two copies by looking at Gleam. There's like 8 to 10 things you can do for entries there. Mm. And then we're also giving away 3 copies live. So just join us Wednesday at 7 p.m. Pacific to win one of those copies. And so that's Wednesday, the week after. Okay, I'm just so excited. We're playing the Werewolf Experiment. It's an escape room game. It is on my desk. I keep opening it and wanting to just rip out all the pieces.
Yeah, that'll be February, first week of February. First Wednesday of February.
Yeah, first Wednesday in February.
Is we're playing. I'm so excited. Jordan's going to produce so that I can play. That's been decided.
And then we might have some special guests from the company coming in that love escape room games.
Yeah.
We will, TBD, we'll just get them nailed down, so. Yeah, we hope to see you all in a few days on Wednesday. It's going to be a really, I don't know, I think it's going to be a much bigger stream than we're used to, so. As far as participants and running the giveaways.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
If you can't make it right away, I think we're going to probably stagger the giveaways throughout the stream. So there'll probably maybe be one to kick things off, and then we'll have 2 more throughout the night. So do tune in. And thanks for joining us for this.
Wednesday at 7. We start at 7 PST.
Yes, and we will do our best to actually be live at
we've
7.
We've gotten pretty good.
No, I think the last time Slugfest came, we were like way late.
I wasn't here.
I know, you were not there. So, yeah, it should be really
every
fun.
Time that comes up, they're like, oh, the stream went so bad. I was like, I was not there. I take zero responsibility.
No, Devilhawk. Well, then enter on the Gleam, because you don't have to be in stream. And I don't think that ends until Friday.
Yeah, we're going to wait till Friday for that one.
So, no, Devilhawk. Devilhawk, you should just quit your job. I think this is, it's really getting in the way of your ability to watch us stream. 30 minutes in my company equals a 13-hour workday. For some people, I don't know. Probably. Depends on what we're playing. Like, this is
chill.
Yeah, you can't get tilted playing Patchwork.
And drinking tea.
Because, like, half of it's, like, luck. It's just, like, where things fall. And, like, you really don't know until the last, like, 3 to 4 turns really how it's gonna end, so.
Yeah,
you can pick up a copy. I think it's like $12 or something on Amazon. It's really worth having in your collection. It's very cheap.
It is a non-expensive game at all. And as I said, definitely recommend it if you're looking for a good two-player game, because two-player games are so hard to find. It's just cute. I think, like, I always tell people, I'm like, ignore the fact that it looks kind of like 90s.
It looks hokey. I mean, you can...
Yeah. Like... I at first, a friend recommended it to me, and I was like, I don't know. And her and I were in the same kind of games. And I looked at it, and I'm like, are you really okay? And she's like, no, trust me. It's really fun. And then when I went into my local board game store, they had it as rated, like, they have a wall that where they, like, the staff rate their top games, and it was in there on the, like, top 10 all crime games that were selling in their store. So I was like, okay, fine. I will buy the game. And I'm so glad it's in my collection.
Yeah, there are games where I'm like, I play it once and I'm like, I will probably never play that again, and that's fine. Like, this one I would expect to, like, keep forever and keep coming back to.
Yes. This is a game, like, John and I pull this out all the time. It's very, like, let's just play Patchwork. Actually, we played it on Tabletop Simulator. And it wasn't as fun because there's something, like, tactile about putting your, like,
you have figuring out,
pieces
yeah.
down. That was kind of cool.
Were you allowed to, like, test and check because it was just so weird probably to, or did you have to, your house rule? You can't actually, like, test?
Oh, we would have had to do, well, you can kind of, like, count. Like, I can be like, that's 2, that's 3 across.
Oh, there you go. There's a link to the,
I think that's to the Kickstarter.
The Kickstarter. I'll do.
Oh, I'm sorry, Doublehawk. I was talking to John, he was like, I think I, oh, my dad actually asked me. He's like, are you playing D&D on Sunday? And I went, no, we're taking that off the air. Our whole two fans were very sad and disappointed with us. That giveaway, there's not currently a giveaway going on, so I don't think that'll work.
Oh, I did the wrong one.
I'm not sure.
There's a Gleam. Oh, I think it's RDI7 Gleam. Is the link. I'm just gonna do a little check here.
It's on Twitter.
Oh wait, oops, I did that incorrectly. It is, okay, I'm just gonna paste it in the chat. There you go, you can go to that link and there's like 8 ways you can win a free copy of Red Dragon Inn, the base game. Yeah, and we'll announce the winner of that by Friday.
On Friday, next week.
Cool.
Probably on Twitter.
Do you have any final comments or thoughts?
No, this was fun. It was relaxing. It's not used to our normal stream when we're...
Yeah, and it was a game we both knew. It was like pretty easy. Yeah.
And I'm so glad we got this working. Guys, this is taking way too long.
Oh, I want... So the problem with jamming a Star Trek one-shot is, like, this system, it's the star system, and no one... So you'd have to, like, learn the system, and it's kind of like... I looked at it, okay, I'll dive into this for, like, 2 seconds,
yeah,
and maybe a thoughts on it. I was looking at some of these one-shots, and, like, a bunch of the... Well, okay, I'll table the other thing I just thought of. The new camera is this one here.
Yeah, it's the one looking above...
Yeah. This probably looks a little different because we actually have, like, pretty good lighting. It's in a smaller space. There's still some backlight behind us.
Well, the one that is looking at us, which actually keeps messing, it doesn't like our lighting right now. That's our, like, better, was our better camera.
Oh, okay.
Before.
So we have 2 good-ish cameras running.
Yeah.
Right now.
But yeah, the overhead one right now is... We decided to try it here, because then you guys get to see all the detail.
Yeah.
I'm going to try to figure out a way that lets me, like, I can, like, as producer, zoom into pieces and so you guys can see it better. We were talking about maybe doing like your document cam, where you can, like, green screen it and bring it
in. For the cards?
Yeah. So you guys, because you guys can't really, when the camera, you guys can't see, but it's, like, far up. It's really, like, way above us right now to give this shot. So you guys can't really, like, hold up cards to it, but if you had, like, a little document camera that was green screened, you could hold it and it would just overlay on top.
Maybe I will look into that for Wednesday. For getting that done for Wednesday. Oh, there's 2 things I'm gonna say. One I saw was, like, some of these systems, like, these one shots, you buy it and it's, like, no rules instruction, like, you learn as you go. And it just tells you how to, like, you just learn as you go,
mm-hmm,
which is interesting. The other system I saw, which was, it's called Dread. Maybe you said something about it. It's with Jenga.
With Jenga, yes.
Have you tried it?
No, I've seen
it. I almost bought it because I was like just the system. And I guess basically it's like, it seems easy. So you start with, like, you build a tower, you take out 5 minus the number of players, tiles to start, and then your characters just, like, try to do something, and the DM can decide, like, if the thing that, like, if they have a hard time doing the thing they want to do, or if it's, like, they're, like, nervous or, like, having a hard time when they do it, you have to, like, pull a Jenga piece to, like, perform the action.
Well, that's the, it's like your skill check, which in D&D you would normally roll a d20 and make your skill check, and in this one you pull a Jenga block.
And there's no dice.
There's no dice. You're just pulling a Jenga.
We have Jenga. You've seen it here. What's I think I saw something like 10 candles. I don't know what that is.
It's so what makes Dread better is playing a horror game on it, because
you want
the intensity, and then adding the Jenga adds to the intensity. So I think that's just a better storytelling mechanism.
Well, I'm guessing you'll have some kind of, like, adrenaline if it's like you're actually legitimately nervous about, like,
yes,
can I actually get this through?
Because you're, like, adrenaline pumping, and then you're like, oh my god, I have to pull a piece, and then, like, if this falls, like,
What happens if it falls? Does the character die?
It's usually on the discretion of the DM. It and depends what they're doing. The character will probably die. It could also be a TPK, depending on what was happening. Usually the character dies.
And you rebuild it?
You would rebuild it if it was just the character dying and not a TPK.
What's TPK?
Total party kill. Depends what you're doing, right? If you're like trying, if you're like, let's say you're in a one of those old like lift elevator, like a thing, and like one of you is making the strength check to pull up the party, and you knock over the Jenga block and you all fall to your death, like that's would be a you would fail and the whole party would die.
Oh my gosh.
Oh my god, what's that?
Okay. Okay, I'll read this.
It's a zero prep tabletop storytelling game designed for one shot, 2 to 4 hour session of tragic horror. With one GM and 3 to 5 players, it's played in the light of 10 tea candles, which provide atmosphere, act as a countdown time for the game, and allow you to literally burn your character sheet away as you play. It's described as a tragic horror game rather than survival horror. In 10 candles, there are no survivors. The final scene of the game, in which only one candle remains, all the characters will die. Oh, that's cool. It's not about winning or beating monsters. It's about what happens in the dark. Wow. That sounds really fun. I also like the fact that like everyone's gonna die, so you like know like this is a storytelling game. Like, oh my gosh. Okay, can I buy it? Let me see how much it is. It's probably like $10.
Can you just get the
PDF is $10. Are there two? Are there two games? Like
Are We Alive?
Maybe like this is like stories. 10 different games. Maybe it's just like prose about the world.
Maybe.
Let's see what you get with 10 candles.
Yeah, and does it give you just the play? Does it give you any like?
Like pre-made mm-hmm. scenarios.
Do I have to look at it? I wanted to do Dread around Halloween and I just didn't have time to prep it.
You're the one that told me about it. Cause like when I read it, I was like, okay, someone definitely told me all about this.
It was definitely me. I've been wanting to run one of these for a while. Cause I love like, I'm actually not a big horror movie fan.
Right.
Because my imagination just gets the best of me.
Oh, I am in my 30s and I'll be like, ha ha ha. Wouldn't it be dumb if there was like a monster in my closet? And then I'm like, it would be.
I do the same thing.
And I'm just like, I am 30, but like, it could be in my closet. Yeah, I get scared of the dark.
Yeah. So I will not watch horror movies. I cannot do horror movies at all.
Oh, wow. Okay. I'll do it. And I'm just like, this is going to be dumb.
But I really like, I like thrillers. And I like telling communal stories, and I think, and what I like with the horror genre in board games and communal stories is like you're creating that world within there and you're telling it, and it versus like just jump scares and
yeah,
psych horror.
So you're not actually like
adds to the intensity, but I don't feel like for whatever reason there's not like nightmare triggering at all.
Yeah, I don't think anything I've ever told myself has been like scared me, but yeah, I'm definitely like an easily scared. Though I think it's kind of fun to be scared sometimes. Like I love a good horror movie and like, you know, around Halloween.
Yeah.
There's no way. There's no his monster in my closet. Then I shut and lock the closet door. Yeah, I do that. And like.
I do that. I like keeping the. I have a really pretty. What are they called? Outside, like a shower curtain. And so I always want the shower. And you don't want to like. So the shower curtain's closed. But there's always like that, ha, there's nothing behind that shower curtain. Okay, there's nothing behind that shower curtain.
Yeah, for me, it's always like just this like big, like, it's not even a closet. It's like, it's just open area next to my, like where my bed is. And it's just like this big cavern. It's like dark inside. And I'm always like, and there's nothing I can do. Like, I can't shut anything. Like if it's in there, it's in there and it's going to kill me. We should look into that. I think that would be really fun, for sure.
There's another one that I really like that I have run before, not on stream, but for friends, which is, it's a system written by Evan Van Norman, and you are playing yourself in a zombie apocalypse.
That's fun.
And you actually like go online and fill out this like 20 question personal questionnaire, and then you spits out your stats. So you have you as a character, and it's like you are playing yourself as if you were in a zombie apocalypse.
That's fun. And it's a one shot? Or it's like a system?
It's a system. You can play it as a one shot. When I was at PAX Unplugged.
The end of the world?
No, it's Outbreak Undead. I think that version 2, I believe, is out. I actually played it with Ivan at PAX Unplugged. He DM'd. So it was really cool.
I really want to try this 10 Candles game.
Yeah, that sounds really cool.
I want to see. I've been spending a ton of money this week, but maybe I'll buy the PDF. Doublehawk, do you know if like just the base PDF has like scenarios in it, or is it up? Do you have to just invent your own? Is there like? Because I would say like when we were playing that the one shot from D&D itself, it was an interesting. We were racing.
Oh, at TwitchCon.
Yeah, like that was fun. Like. If it had something like a cool scenario just like that, just like baked in, I think it'd be easier.
Yeah.
I've always wanted to try like DMing something, but I've never done it before.
It's not.
I'm scared. I think it'd be better if it has scenarios. Okay. Because that'd be easier for your first time. I think you'd have to like learn.
That's the thing. Yeah, there are good systems. They have to be easy to pick up, or I find what's good with RPG system, like storytelling games, is you don't actually need to know all the mechanics to play. Like, you could be like, I want to do this, and the DM will be like, okay, cool, to do that I need you to do this, and you're like, oh, okay, this is how you would pass this, and you didn't need to know all those mechanics until the DM was like, here, do this. And I think that helps, like your DM has to know.
Yeah, that's probably why I haven't done it. And that's why the Star Trek one shot. Though I have all the books. Like I scoured and found all these books that are like out of print now. Just kind of sad. Fucking yeah. Wizards of the Coast. Bought the rights to that system, and then same with Star Wars. They totally ruined the collectible card game.
I've heard good things about the new Star Wars RPG system.
I have. Okay, that was like in the top 10 list of the, like, of course, D&D, like, most of the books were D&D, and there was a few other, like, medieval kind of themed, like...
There's a friend of mine who works here has talked about the D&D system endlessly, and he keeps promising me that he's going to run a game for me. And I was like, okay, I'm going to hold you to this. You're going to play. He hasn't yet. I'll go give him a hard time.
Sure.
But yeah, we're thinking about RPG content, but probably it'll be like an event more than actually like a regular stream. Yeah.
Like randomly. We could even think about using some of the Wednesday nights for it.
With our giant backlog of games.
That's true. But like, we just add this to the backlog. Like, we probably have enough games to go through, like, lead us to summer without even like thinking about anything new.
Yeah.
Let alone like, there are some new games coming out. No one told Fiaka there's no more D&D stream. There's no more D&D stream. He's like sitting there like
no idea. He's like prepped and waiting for all the lists. Like, why isn't anyone showing up?
If you ever got a chance to finally play a tabletop RPG, I really want to play Deadlands Reloaded. Wait, Double, have you not ever played a tabletop RPG?
I find with
Wait, is D&D a tabletop RPG?
Yes.
But like 5th edition, but like other editions are those considered?
No. Any like what you're thinking of RPG at
the
table.
Oh, he's just never played it. Okay, I was just thinking like there are different editions where like there is no board or tokens, and it's just like.
Yeah, it's still. That's not true. It was Sunday, and we had Doublehawk would show up, and Penguin would show up sometimes, and then we just played ourselves.
Yeah.
And it was so much work to like set up and prep. Although I'm here on a Sunday setting up and prepping, but this was for Wednesday.
Like a one-off. This was a one-shot. This was a one-shot.
This is a one-off. Yeah.
There's also a lot of people doing RPG content on the weekends, I've noticed.
Yeah, because usually you want to play like longer than, like we only play 2 hours, but a lot of people play longer. I'm still defending you for the audience. We're actually still going to play offline without any setup, and it'll be like less often just for us, like as friends, because we enjoyed playing. We enjoyed playing our characters, and everyone loves John DMing. So we're probably just going to play once in a while offline.
But hopefully, when is John Renew in town next? Maybe we can do one of these one shots in person.
I mean, he's coming to. He's fine, but he's coming. It's like, I don't know if I should share his schedule. He'll be here on Thursday this week, but then he's leaving on Tuesday.
So it'd have to be like next weekend.
So it wouldn't really work because we have plans.
See, I never have plans.
But no, he's back in March.
I'm looking in that 10 candles thing.
I mean, I can. John likes. John is always. I'm not gonna say stuck DMing, but you know, when someone becomes like the DM, they always end up having to DM.
I will DM it.
It would be nice for him to be a player.
That's what I mean. Yeah. I will DM it. I will DM. Well, okay. I will buy the 10 candles and read it, and then try to DM it. I didn't think the whole setup was cool. I think it looked great on stream. It reminds me a little bit of like the Lark lamp.
Yeah.
It seemed to look really cool. Yeah. Cool. So I think that's all we've got.
Yes.
So do check out the Gleam. Shoot. If you want to enter to win Red Dragon Inn 7 or Red Dragon Inn, the vanilla game, celebrating the Red Dragon Inn 7 launch, I will be back Wednesday at 7 p.m. Pacific, and you can join us there. Give us a follow on Twitter if you want to learn more about our upcoming events. And I think that's all.
Yeah.
Thanks to everyone who stopped by today. It was fun. Hopefully you enjoyed the new camera setup. We'll continue working on it and making it better. And just to say, like, the camera setup did come from all the support we received in the last year. So, like, this was totally funded by people that watch the stream and have donated and given us bits and subscribed. So thanks, you guys, so much. Like, we are putting it back into the stream. Heroic Logic, good night. Thanks for stopping by.
Yeah. So that's all. Switch over.
Bye.
Bye, everyone.
Are we going to do a raid?
Maybe not.
We can find someone. Okay, we're going to try to find someone to raid.
Oh, God, where's my...
Pardon our dust. We're looking. It's been kind of nice not seeing myself on the screen.
Oh, please don't come up. Okay. We want communities, board games.
Oh wow, there are a thousand
watching that. Oh, this looks like a...
Oh, it's Warhammer.
It's Warhammer, and it's a finals. Las Vegas Open. That's like the championship for wargaming.
I think we can make it into the Las Vegas Open Patchwork.
This one looks nice.
Yeah.
Food chain magnet.
Oh, Charterstone. They're on game 4. Okay, I can't look at that. Spoilers.
Spoilers. That one's a rerun. So let's go this one.
Yeah, let's do it. Okay, we're going to... we are going to raid Null Patrol playing Food Chain Magnet. How do you say that word? Magnate? I think it's Magnate.
I don't know.
I've only ever read it. I've never said it out loud.
Magnate. Oh, God. Okay.
No, it's in the chat.
I think you have to... Wait.
I can do it. Okay. See, on the 10 Candles website, I think there's a link to a few playthroughs that people have done if you want to check it out. Okay, I will definitely check that out.
Let me join chat. I'm gonna go.
Okay, we are going to raid. Please say hello. Use the Twitch raid thing.
Twitch raid thing.
The email. We'll see everyone over there.
Hopefully this will work.
Thanks for stopping by, everyone.
Bye, good night.
See you on Wednesday.